Inserting a new node is where the magic happens. There are several different states of the tree and the node you're inserting that require different courses of action. Remember that your resulting tree needs to follow both the red-black tree and BST rules. There's a lot of information here. Your first goal should be to watch and get a sense of how red-black trees work. You can rewatch the video later to actually memorize the details. One overall rule of insertion is that you should try to insert a node as a red node, which from here on out I'll represent as both red and square to help with differentiation, and then change its color as needed. The first situation is when you're inserting the first node into the tree. Since it's the root, you can change the color to black if you're adhering to the root must be black rule. Otherwise, you'll have nothing to do. If the new parent node is black, you don't need to do any work. Since you're adding a red node, you haven't upset the balance of black nodes in any path or violated any of the other rules. Now, if the parent is red, there are several cases with more complicated solutions. If the parent and its sibling are both red, then they should be changed to black, and their parent, the grandparent, let's say, of the node you're inserting, becomes red. We switch the node colors in this way to maintain the number of black nodes in a given path. Look through all the paths in this tree. The number of black nodes in each path is still 2. The biggest problem here is that we could have violated another property by changing the grandparent. We can just treat the grandparent as a newly inserted node and change it or its ancestors according to the same cases and rules. Here, we just treat it like case 1 and change it back to black, since we still want the root to be black.